I'm Dr. SriniVas Sadda. I'm a professor of ophthalmology at the Doheny Eye Institute and the University of California, Los Angeles. Another really exciting technology is the introduction of ICG to this wide field platform. Historically, we saw how with the introduction of OCT, how the scope of angiography seemed to be narrowing, but then ultra-wide field angiography became available. We started to collect all of this great data and the scope has suddenly expanded. And I'm expecting something similar with ICG. The reality is that we didn't know until we had ultra-wide field angiography what was out there in the very far periphery. I mean, yes, with these kind of montage views we were collecting before, we could get out there a little ways, but not to the periphery like we can achieve with new technologies. And the introduction of the ICG to the Optos platform is going to be huge. And we can think of some of the applications right away where I think it's going to be of great interest. One, of course, is going to be uveitides. I mean, clearly, those are diseases where there's a lot of action in the periphery, and looking at the posterior pole is just not addressing all that's going on. And ICG is a big component of evaluating patients with uveitis. One of the great advantages of wide-field imaging that we've had is that we've been able to get a single shot of the eye and be able to see everything and not have to obtain montage views. And for angiography, that's especially critical, where you want to try to capture everything in one phase. I'm really excited about the new Optos device and its really small footprint. We've recently moved into a new office and, you know, we've got a lot of imaging equipment and not a lot of space. And, you know, every square foot is precious. And having a device that's multimodal capable but still occupy a small footprint is pretty huge given that consideration.